Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to a new video of GTM Designs. Thank you everyone for your positive comments. As you guys requested, here is the tutorial. In this video, we will see how to create a cinematic scene inside Blender. But we are not going to do the modeling and texturing process. We are only going to focus on setting a scene with effective steps. Normally when I am creating a scene, I will have some kind of reference or concept art. But while doing this particular scene, I am trying to find out the layout which suits the statue we have here. Before creating the layout, I would like to introduce a special course. This course takes your Blender and Eve motion graphics skills to next level. Over 11 hours of training covering procedure modeling, quick animation techniques, shading and lighting tips, Eve optimization and more. Yeah, please check it out. Without further ado, let's dive back to our video. Here, I am selecting the assets that we want in our scene. Now, here is the magic happens. In Blender, we have a tool called Group Instance. It's a life changer in creating large environments. It really helps to reduce the size of the work files. As you can see, I am assigning each object into different collections. And now I am creating each object as collection instance. So now we have all object that we imported from Quixel bridge as collection instance. Now we want to set its origin to geometry, so that we can duplicate the object as many times that we want. It won't affect the size of the work file. Okay then, we can create the camera to block out the layout. I am pressing Ctrl+Alt+0 to snap the camera to a POV. It's time to arrange the object to create good composition. Here, you can see I am arranging the object. Rearranging and reordering its shape, size and position to create a better composition. I am planning to place the statue as center of attention and BG to enhance its importance. Also, I am planning to make the sunbeam hitting on the statue from the top, so that we can create a cylindrical object, which helps us to create that effect. To create depth, I am placing a mountain in a distance. I am going to change the passy pass out to 1 and the color of the floor to black. It's time to place the major light source in the scene. Here there are two main light sources. The first one is set as blue color and the second one to be yellow. Okay then, it's time to create the volumetric. To add volumetric in the scene, I am going to create a cube and scale it out to fit the entire BG. And add a new material. Remove the surface attribute and add volumetric scatter to volume attribute. I am tweaking the power attributes of light source to enhance the sun rays. We just need a simple smooth animation here. Our volumetric cube is blocking the view, so we can change its viewport display as wire. It will help us to see the BG properly. We are missing the front layer in the composition, so we can use this object, place it as a front layer. The front layer makes the BG to look more dynamic. Adding depth of field is one of the major things all the cinematographer loves to create in a movie. Inside Blender, we have ultimate options to change the aperture below 1.4. Here, I am playing around with the depth of field to bring the scene to life. I am also tweaking slight movements to the sun rays. As I am moving through the animation, something feels off at the front side of the statue. So I am planning to add a little light source at the front, and we can hide this light source with some kind of plant or something. It's time to create smoke simulation. For smoke simulation, we need two major things, domain and flow. For flow, we are going with the landscape. I am going to create landscape and parent the landscape with a circular curve so that we can animate the landscape in a circular path. After animating the landscape, we can create the domain by pressing F3 and search for QuickSmoke. Press on it, then we can see a cube popping on the viewport. It is called domain. Then we can bake the smoke simulation. Here, we need a smoke simulation which dissolves at a particular time after emitting. we need to tweak some settings inside flow and inside domain. Yeah, we got the smog simulation ready. It's time to create the particle simulation. Create a plane or a surface and go to the particle settings inside property tab. From there, press on the plus button, then a particle system will be created. From there, we can tweak some settings as we need. Here, I am going to create a sphere and set it as a particle instance. And for the dissolving effect, I have used this node. Yeah, you can see the node here. This node was used to create that symbol dissolving effect. That really enhanced the scene a lot. You can download a node for free. Here, I will show you the process of creating the camera movement. It is quite simple. Check it out. I've been dreaming on in my head like I've seen it. A life worth living is a life with meaning. I'll do what I love till my heart stops beating. I'm feeding this demon. Got a taste, can't erase bitterness in my face. Work a job every day till your dreams fade away. Like a card, never change, play the game that we say. I need a break. I'm staying strong, need to move on to be what I want. I'll keep dreaming on. I'm staying strong, need to move on to be what I want. I'll keep dreaming on. There are many types of camera movements like pan, tilt, zoom, dolly, truck, etc. Understanding the effects of different type of camera movements in film is essential for every filmmakers to understand. It not only makes a better cinematographer or director, but better storyteller. Using the right movement at the best serves your story will help you to make each shot as effective as possible. And that's all, guys. Thank you for watching.